We're gonna show you one of the operations areas of this building. This is the fifth floor. It has a mix of new and old equipment. And one of the cool things about these, I personally think is neat, is we keep all the lights off and we have individual light switches per row. So I'm gonna walk down the rows and turn on the lights so you can see what's going on in all these rows. And you can see we have everything from old phone company equipment to fiber, power distribution, more modern racks with equipment in them. It's part of our voice system at this site that is voice over IP. We're gonna walk around and I'm gonna show you the fiber in this site. And in this site, because this is a special type of central office, this is a what we call a primary center. It carries traffic between other central offices. This one doesn't actually serve customers directly. What it does is connect our offices to each other, which makes the amount of fiber in it even more impressive. And I'll show you. We have lots of space for expansion. If you look down these rows, I like looking at these because I think about all the things we can do in the future with the space because it's just there and ready to go. But if you come over here, you can see our fiber that goes between buildings. And these fiber cables are big. They go floor to ceiling. Most data centers use 6-foot racks. We don't use 6-foot racks. As you can tell, we use 16-foot racks. So right here, we've got a modern fiber patch panel. This is a 144 count cable. You can see numbers 1 through 144, top to bottom, left to right. These are directly mapped to individual cables. Those individual cables either leave the building or go to specific pieces of equipment in the building. As you can see in these panels, we actually have tons and tons of cross connects available. Lots of empty ports ready for expansion. And that's by design. We don't want to be in a situation where we can't turn something up because we don't have a panel installed, don't have the appropriate cables pulled. And that goes all the way to our cables between offices. And that's one of our unique advantages as Ziply Fiber. We can go and provision services quite quickly internally, and we often have routes that other people don't have. And that's not unique to this site. That's really common amongst our sites. They're all designed around not having our services fail. And you see it in the reliability of the services. On this side, you get a remnant of the DSL era. These are actually DS3 or T3 connections. Hardly any of these are used anymore, except for the voice network. But we, of course, keep them in service for the remaining customers that are on them. As you move down this way, you can see our older fiber transport gear. This carries some of the services that have been around quite a long time. And we'll go down to the fourth floor to see our modern transport gear. This is all Fujitsu FlashWave equipment that was here and is gonna continue to be here for quite a while, carrying older voice services. We get everything at this site. This is old T1 transponders that do in 1.5 megabit DS1s to various places around the network. These have been in service for many years, but they're used for things you don't realize. If you have an older PBX, for example, and you want to do voice to it, they often take T1s. And even VoIP uses some of that traditional telephone network. And one of the things that I always remind people is because we are the phone company in our area, we actually operate the voice switches to which most of the carriers end up connecting to deliver local calls. And so at some point, most VoIP calls end up on the old TDM network, and that's T1s carry between switches, and we'll show you a voice switch in this building so you can see what those voice switches look like, because while they're old technology, they're still very important to our lives every day as we make those calls. Some of our older phone customers actually have voicemail service, and this is where their voice messages live. You know, we always like to point out, you think it's a cloud-based service, well, this is the kind of stuff running that cloud. It lives physically somewhere, and that's something people like to forget. So this is a copper cross-connect frame. While we don't use these to deliver new services very often, they're important and they're super critical to our voice infrastructure. This office contains a lot of 911 switching, so you'll see all of these are flagged with being 911 circuits. And each individual circuit goes through either 2 or 4 wires that are twisted together through this cross-connect frame. And as you can see, this cross-connect frame goes on a long way. And that's really kind of a demonstration of the scale we're at. This is one of our smaller frames. We have frames like this that go on for several hundred feet, but they're critical to delivering even those copper services in a reliable fashion. Each one of these cables goes from the source to the destination through these racks. And these are designed to be able to maintain those connections even while you're working on other connections, because you can't take down a service to one user while you're working another. And our copper while it was the originator of that strategy, our fiber follows the same exact strategy. What we saw today was examples of our network and what we're building to provide you service regardless of what you're doing with those internet connections. We're data-centric and we're building that data network ever bigger to serve you with faster and faster speeds every day, whether you're gaming, streaming, video conferencing, or just simply watching TV at night online with a streaming account. We want it to work every day, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. And that's why we put so much effort into this infrastructure, and that's why I'm proud to show it to you today.